Okay, so let's talk about why I'm combining the orchestra and band videos together. Well, on Flipgrid, I'm seeing a bunch of different types of angles on your cameras, whether you're using your laptop, iPad, computer, webcam, mobile device like an iPhone or Android phone or some sort. I'm getting all these different angles, and a lot of the angles aren't really well or good for me to be assessing you. Now, I'm not trying to say that what you're doing is bad. Well, kind of. What I'm saying is I need to be able to see the whole instrument. That includes not just your face or not just your instrument, but both the face and your hands, especially on the instrument. For example, we have a lot of the orchestra students. I can see just your head. I can't see what your left hand's doing or your right hand is doing either, so I don't know what strings you're on. I know a lot of you are still having trouble tuning by yourself your strings, and know that I understand that completely. You're not in the classroom, so it's really hard to tune it on your own if you're not really used to it, or you don't have a family member that can help you in the household. I get that. However, I can still assess whether or not you're doing the right skills or techniques that I'm teaching you. You may not hear the same melody like you would in the videos, or that you would play if the instrument was in tune. However, I can see what you're doing with your hands, and I can tell you then what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong. Otherwise, I just think you're playing wrong notes all the time. Now, so find good angles for yourself from the camera, whether it be a webcam, your laptop, mobile device, or whatever it might be. In this video, I'm going to show you a few good angles to try. The best idea overall is to be away from your camera, not right up close to it. The closer you are, the less I see, right? So the farther away you are, the more I can get from the perspective where I can see what your hand is doing. Also, for my band people, you guys are getting just your face, or some of the things you're lacking are just not seeing you at all. I have some of you that are turning the opposite direction from the camera for some reason. I guess it's because of lack of space from where your music stand is to the camera. Try to maneuver it somehow so that way you're music is between you and the camera, that way I can still see you and you can still see the music when you're recording yourself. Please don't try to turn your back to the camera or I can't see what you're doing. So try to get away from the camera to get more of your body, especially your hands and your mouth for band people, so I can see what your embouchure is doing and I can see where your fingers are going on the keys. And with that being said, I have some videos of that as well, of some good angles to try. If you're using a mobile device, try to use landscape mode or make the camera horizontal so I can see the wide aspect of it all, especially for those flute players, trumpets, trombones, especially trombones, violins and violas. The other instruments like saxophone, clarinet, bass, cello, the ones that are more vertical, bassoon, oboe, try to get it in portrait or up vertically so I can get the full instrument, including your body. That's going to help a lot on the aspects of the camera angle, and I can give you or Mrs. Bryant can give you some good technique advice or some critique on what to work on and what's lacking in your performance. Otherwise, if I just see your face and not the instrument, I have no idea what's happening. Only what I hear, and I can tell you, well, it's wrong, but there's no specifics as what you're doing that you can improve on. Or I can say, oh, I see what you're doing there. There's a little spot where your finger's going that it shouldn't be. Or there's a key you're pressing that you shouldn't be pressing at all. Or maybe you have the wrong fingering because you're using one finger for a different key that you're supposed to. Those different things. If we can't see those, we can't give you that advice to help you. So always, always step away from the camera, give yourself some room. If you need to if you need to edit it because you feel like it's taking too long to go between the camera and the playing part of it all, you can edit that and trim it down in Flipgrid if you want to, if you're that kind of a stickler about it. Otherwise, I don't really care. As long as I get from point A to point B in your recording of you starting the music, introducing yourself, counting it off, playing, and then ending it on the right way, and playing it correctly, I don't really care how all the other cool effects you can do on it. And have fun with that if you can. Obviously, it's there for your enjoyment as well as much as mine. But my goal is to be able to see what you're doing and how you're learning and how I can help you. Okay? So take some time to watch these videos of the do's and don'ts on recording yourself for Flipgrid or playing assessments, playing tests.
Let's start off with the bass. So in this video, you can tell from this perspective, I can't see what my left hand is doing, nor my right hand is doing. And it's best if you just pull the camera away, so that way I can see both the left hand and the right hand. I can see what strings I'm manipulating for the plucking, or bowing for that matter, and what my left hand is doing, what my posture is like, and what my wrist is like. And I can see clearly everything. Here we have the violin viola. You can see I'm plucking. You don't know what strings I'm plucking. You can tell that I don't have a shoulder rest because my head is just freely bouncing around, and I don't know what my left hand is doing, so I'm not sure what is happening. In this angle, we can see clearly that I am plucking a specific string. I have my shoulder rest in place. My left arm is straight. My wrist is straight. I can see what strings I'm manipulating with my left hand, what fingering I'm using, and you can pretty much tell where those fingers are going. Let's take a look at the cello. I can clearly see my face. I'm doing a lot of moving around. I can see that my fingers are moving. I just don't know what is happening with my left hand or my right hand. Looks like I'm having a good time though. I'm playing a lot of fast stuff, but yeah, you can't really tell. Step away the camera or pull back the camera and I can see everything now, my left hand and my right hand, and I can see my posture clearly, what's happening with my arm and my relationship to the cello itself. Now I can see what's happening, I can hear what's happening. Here we have the saxophone. I'm not wearing a neck strap. My head and my jaw is tilted down. It looks like I'm taking my mouth off the mouthpiece constantly between rests, and I'm moving around a lot. It's keeping it really hard for me to take focus. I don't know what I just did there. And here we have now me standing up. I have it in portrait mode on my camera, so I can see now the entire instrument. I can also see what my fingers are doing. I can still clearly see my mouthpiece, my embouchure. I can see where my fingers are all going. Best part about this is I'm using my neck strap properly. Here we have our clarinet. We're just too close to the camera. I don't know what my left hand is doing, but I can clearly see what my embouchure is doing. Now I just switched hands. I'm taking a big breath and taking the mouthpiece out. These are lots of don'ts. Don't do any of this I just did. Make sure that we're holding the instrument properly like we have here. And for added angle just a little bit, you can see now that the thumb is moving back and forth, so I know when you're employing that thumb and when you're not using it. You can also tell that my left hand is doing a lot of the work on the keys, but my right hand is holding it up. Here we have the instrument fully placed. Eventually, we're going to start using the entire instrument on the clarinet, not just the upper joint. And so I have to see what your left hand is doing as well as your right hand. Pull the camera back a little bit, stand it a little bit at an angle, and now I can see all the fingers that you're using, including your embouchure. And I'm seated here. I don't have to stand up for that, though you can stand if you'd like to. That's all up to you. Next, we have the trombone. Oh, don't buy this trombone. This was just for fun. I really liked that blue color, so I bought it for myself. However, the important part about this is that I can't see all the slide positions. I can see that you're probably playing super loud because you're really close to the microphone on the camera, but that's not conducive to a good recording session. Again, pull the camera away from you, step back, put it in landscape mode or put it horizontal so I can see the full extent of all seven positions when you're playing your trombone.
Well, I hope you got the gist of what I'm talking about here in these videos. It's all about angles. And another thing to think about is if you're farther away from the camera, because a lot of these mobile devices or devices that you use have a microphone built in, the better sound quality you'll get, because the closer you are to the camera, the louder you'll be with your instrument, and it'll start distorting the sound quality. And so a lot of the devices we use don't have that automatic balance feature where they turn down the gain or the amount of sound it can carry within the device before it just starts distorting the sound. So the farther away you are from the camera, the better sound quality you get, and I can see you better. So take this advice, take it with you, and use it in your flip recordings from now on. Hope to see the next one and see it so much better.